Hello children, welcome to my lecture. Today we are going to do history of English drama. Means today we are going to study 4.1 history of English drama. In this chapter children, already we are taking introduction regarding the English drama. We learn the definition of English drama. Afterwards we learn the elements of drama. Then we are taking information regarding the elements. We also learn objectives of English drama. We learn four closely related area regarding English drama, and afterwards we learn the types of English drama. So they are tragedy, comedy and tragic comedy, these three types. And we also taken information regarding the tragedy drama, comedy drama and tragic comedy drama. Now today we are going to learn a short history of drama. See children, number one point, introduction to English drama, or we can say introduction to English theatre. Drama has its origin in folk theatre. We therefore cannot consider drama merely as a part of literature. Words are the medium of literature as an art, but drama is a multiple art using words, scenic effect, music, gestures of the actors and the organizing talent of a producer. The dramatist must have players, a stage and an audience. See, folk theater. So children, drama has its origin in folk theater. We can say due to its origin in folk theater, drama is not considered an exclusive part of literature. Children, literature is a form of art that is expressed through the use of words. On the other hand, drama is considered to be a multiple art form since it uses words, scenic effect, music, gesture. Gestures means acting of the actors. And organizing talent. Organization of talent means of prodigious work in its expression. So children, jo English drama hai, uska origin folk theater se शुरू होता है. तो हम कह सकते हैं कि ड्रामा क्या है, यह लिटरेचर का एक पार्ट नहीं है. वर्ड्स आर द मीडियम ऑफ लिटरेचर. वर्ड्स जो हैं लिटरेचर के मीडियम है, बट ड्रामा में क्या है, मल्टीपल थिंग्स है. यहाँ पर वर्ड्स यूज किए जाते हैं, सीनिक इफेक्ट यूज किया जाता है, म्यूजिक यूज किया जाता है, जेस्चर ऑफ एक्टर मीन्स एक्टर्स की एक्टिंग यूज की जाती है, एंड ऑर्गेनाइजिंग टैलेंट ऑफ प्रोड्यूसर. और प्रोड्यूसर क्या करता है, टैलेंट्स को ऑर्गेनाइज करता है और ड्रामा को प्रोड्यूस करता है. तो इसलिए हम यह कह सकते हैं द ड्रामेटिस्ट मस्ट हैव प्लेयर, अ स्टेज एंड ऑडियंस. द बिगनिंग ऑफ ड्रामा इन इंग्लैंड आर ऑब्सक्योर. ऑब्सक्योर मीन नॉट डिस्कवर्ड. चिल्ड्रेन, वी ऑलरेडी नो इन इंग्लैंड इंग्लिश ड्रामा इज नॉट स्टार्टेड बाय द इंग्लिश पीपल. देयर इज एविडेंस टू बिलीव दैट व्हेन द रोमन्स वर इन इंग्लैंड दे एस्टेब्लिश्ड वास्ट एम्पीथिएटर फॉर द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ प्ले, बट व्हेन द रोमन्स डिपार्टेड देयर थिएटर डिपार्टेड विद देम. सो चिल्ड्रन, व्हेन द रोमन्स वर इन इंग्लैंड दे एस्टेब्लिश्ड वास्ट एम्पीथिएटर्स फॉर द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ प्ले, बट व्हेन द रोमन्स लेफ्ट the amphitheater tradition also left with them. In short, we can say the drama, it is not started by English people in England. There is lot of evidences over there. Drama is started in English by the Roman people or amphitheater. Amphitheater means open theater. See, तो ये जो Romans थे, उन्होंने ही amphitheater शुरू किया for the production of play. लेकिन जब Romans जो है move out कर दिए इंग्लैंड से, तो उन्होंने उनके साथ अपना जो एम्पी थिएटर था वो भी लेकर चले गए. देन देयर वेयर मिनिस्ट्रेल्स. पीपल एंजॉयड देयर परफॉर्मेंस. देयर वेयर मिनिस्ट्रेल्स. मिनिस्ट्रेल्स मीन्स म्यूजिकल परफॉर्मेंस. सो दैट टाइम पीपल्स देयर एंजॉयिंग द म्यूजिकल परफॉर्मेंस एंड एंटरटेनिंग ओन सेल्फ. Gradually by the 10th century, the ritual of the play that itself had something dramatic in it got extended into the rudiment of a play. So children, first of all question arises, what is meant by rudiment? Rudiments means a basic element of play. By the 10th century, drama, which used to be just a part of play, becomes fundamental elements of the play itself. तो बच्चों, जब रोमेंस जो है अपने एमपी थिएटर्स को लेकर चले गए, तो इंग्लैंड में कोई भी इंटरटेनमेंट का जरिया नहीं था, उसमें सिर्फ एक मैजिकल परफॉर्मेंस था जिसको देखकर लोग अपना एंजॉयमेंट करते थे। सो 10th सेंचुरी में क्या हो गया, देखिए, सो ग्रेजुअली बाय द 10th सेंचुरी द रिचुअल ऑफ द प्ले दैट इटसेल्फ हैड समथिंग ड्रामेटिक इन इट गॉट एक्सटेंडेड इनटू द रूडिमेंट ऑफ प्ले। सो 10th सेंचुरी में जो एक पार्ट था ड्रामा का, उसने ही अपना क्या किया, फंडामेंटल मतलब बेसिक आधार प्ले का ले लिया। सी नेक्स्ट पैराग्राफ। बिटवीन द 13th एंड द 14th सेंचुरी ड्रामा स्टार्टेड हैविंग थीम विच वर सेपरेटेड फ्रॉम रिलीजन। द वर्ड्स देमसेल्फ वर स्पोकन इन इंग्लिश। ए लॉन्गर ड्रामेटिक स्क्रिप्ट केम इन टू यूज एंड दे वर कॉल्ड मिरेकल प्लेस। चिल्ड्रन, ड्यूरिंग द 12th सेंचुरी इन ऑर्डर टू अट्रैक्ट मोर इंटरेस्ट इन चर्च सर्विसेज प्ले बेस्ड ऑन बाइबल इवेंट्स एंड द लाइव्स ऑफ द सन्स नोन एज मिस्ट्री प्लेस और वी कैन से दे नोन एज मिरेकल प्लेस। सो मिस्ट्री प्लेस एंड मिरेकल प्लेस वर परफॉर्म्ड एज ए पार्ट ऑफ चर्च सर्विसेज Gradually, during the 13th century, these plays began being performed out of the church. But in between the 13th and 14th century, drama started having theme which were separated from religion. By this period, miracle plays has become less religious, the language were switched to the English and a longer dramatic script came into use. So children, in 13th and 14th century, drama started having a theme. This drama started separating from religious play. The words themselves were spoken in English and now in drama, longer dramatic script came into use. And this script or this type of drama is and the drama which had the longer script, that drama is known as the miracle place. Next para. Later, these religious drama were the mortality plays in which characters were abstract, vices and virtues. These were allegories. See children, vices means bad and virtues means good. And children, allegories means a type of play in which the character represent good and bad moral qualities. And that type of drama is known as allegories. Again, I am revising. Allegories, it is a type of drama. In this type of drama, or we can say in this type of play, character represents good and bad moral qualities. So children, previous this plays are the miracle plays and afterward this plays becomes a mortality play. So we can say later the mortality play in which the character themselves were a representation of good and bad qualities were used to teach moral and religious lessons. These plays were known as allegories. तो बच्चों जो long script के play आए उन्हें हमने कहा miracle plays. और बाद में यही religious जो drama था यह क्या बन गया, mortality play बन गया. इसमें characters जो थे वो अभिनय करते थे, कोई उसमें गुड क्वालिटीज का रोल निभाता था तो कोई यहाँ पर बैड क्वालिटी का रोल निभाता था. और इस टाइप का जो ड्रामा था उसे हम क्या कहते हैं, एलोगरेस। लेट्स स्टार्ट द एलिजाबेथन एंड रेस्टोरेशन ड्रामा और वी कैन से थिएटर। दिस सेकुलर मोर्टेलिटी प्ले हैव डायरेक्ट लिंक विद एलिजाबेथन प्ले। सो चिल्ड्रन, दिस मोर्टेलिटी प्लेस मार्क द एंड ऑफ ड्रामा बेस्ड ऑन द बाइबल and paved the way for the Elizabethan plays. The Renaissance imposed a learned tradition, classical in depth with theme of education, general moral problems and secular politics. The plays had nothing to do with religion. There were examples of both comedy and tragedy. Thomas Kyd, Christopher Marlowe and William Shakespeare are the prime dramatists of this era. So children, the English Renaissance was cultural and artistic movement in England, which laid the ground for art and drama in country. It was believed that during the classical period, the art and science had greatly flourished. With this in mind, the Renaissance focused on bringing back classical value and hence introduced classical theme of education, general moral problems and secular politics. The play had nothing to do with religion. There were examples of both comedy and tragedy. Children, Thomas Keats, Christopher Marlowe and William Shakespeare are the notable dramatists, or we can say prime dramatists of this era. It was Kidd who discovered how easily blank verse might be converted into a useful theoretical medium, which Shakespeare used brilliantly in all his plays. Tragedy developed in the hand of Kidd and Marlowe. Comedy has also proceeded beyond rustic humor. But by the 19th of the 16th century, the theater in England was fully established, but complicated conditions governed the activities of the dramatist. Children, Kidd discovered the blank verse poem. So question arises, what is meant by blank verse poem? The poem not have a rhyming scheme, or we can say the poem not having any rhyming word, that poem is a blank verse. So children, John Kidd discovered the blank verse can be used in theater, and that was extensively used by Shakespeare in his all plays. Tragedy developed in the hand of Kidd and Marlowe. And we can say children, tragedy developed by the Kidd and Marlowe. Comedy had also proceeded beyond rustic humor, but by the 19th of 16th century, the theater in England was fully established, but complicated conditions governed the activities of the dramatist. Children, comedy has proceeded rustic humor, but in 19th of the 16th century, the theater of England were fully established, but it is what? But it is in complicated condition. The public theater of the 16th century differed in many important ways from the modern theater. It was open to sky without artificial lighting. The stage was raised platform with the recess at the back supported by pillars. There was no curtain, and the main platform could be surrounded on three sides by the audience. Around the theater, there were galleries. In the 17th century, the enclosed theater gained importance. There was increasing attention to scenic device as theater became private. So children, in 16th century, the theater were different from our today's type of theater, or we can say the public theater of 16th century is different in many important way from our modern theater. So it was open sky, it is not having any artificial light. The stage were raised platforms, and with the recess at back supported by three pillars. Means stage is what? It is back supported by three pillars. There was no curtain, and main platform is surrounded by three side audience. Means वहाँ पर जो main platform है जहाँ पर जो character play करते थे drama, वह तीनों side से audience से घिरा हुआ होता था. Around the theater there were galleries. In the 17th century, enclosed theater is gained important, and there was increasing attention to scenic device as theater become a now private children. See, Shakespearean era came into existence in 16th century to the public theater. He wrote for the contemporary theater, manipulating the Elizabethan stage with great resource and invention. But the genius of Shakespeare should not the rest of the drama of his age to be obscured. Obscured means not discovered. Children, 16th century is known as Shakespearean era. Shakespeare wrote for the contemporary theater, manipulating the Elizabethan stage with great resources and invention. But the genius Shakespeare not allowed the rest of drama of his age to be not discovered. In another way, we can say, while Shakespeare ruled the public stage with his intelligence and innovation, the contribution of his peers to the drama of the period cannot be ignored. Contemporary to him was Ben Jonson, a classicist, a moralist, and a reformer of drama. In comedy, Jonson's genius is found at the base, and his influence was considerable. The Restoration dramatist learned strong upon him. Contemporaries to him was Ben Jonson. Children, dramatist Ben Jonson, who belonged to that period, was a classicist, a moralist, and a reformer of drama. He was known for his work in comedy and greatly influenced dramatists in the Restoration
period.
Which period? Restoration period, children? The period which came late. And now, the restoration dramatists leaned strongly upon him. Closing the theatres by the Puritans in 1642 brought this greatest of all period in the history of English drama to an end. With the civil wars, no theatre exists between 1642 to 1660. The next phase, which appeared after the restoration, produced a very different kind of dramatic literature. Dramatists like Chapman, Thomas Middleton, Webster and Dekker were at the forefront. See children, by the 1519, English theatre was fully established. As compared to the modern theatre, 16th century public theatre was open to the sky without artificial light. The stage was a raised platform with the recess at the back supported by pillars. There was no curtain and the main platform could not be supported on three sides by the audience. And main platform could be supported on three sides by the audience. Around the theater, there were galleries. Children, in 1642, Puritans began to close theaters and thus ended the golden period of English drama. Due to the civil war. Why it is closed? Due to the civil war, no theater exists between 1642 to 1660. When the Charles II came back with the restoration in 1660, the theater were reopened. The restoration comedy achieved in peculiar existence. Drama developed into class drama with upper class ethos. It lasted beyond this period into the first decade of the 18th century. Comedy in the early 18th century declined into sentimentalism. So children, in this period, notable works are Romeo and Juliet, that is tragedy, A Midsummer Night Dream, that is a comedy, and Henry IV, it is a historical drama, all written by William Shakespeare. Dr. Faustus and Jew of Malta by Christopher Marlowe, Duchess of Murphy by John Webster. Next is The Challenging by Thomas Middleton. This is the achievement of this century dramatist. Now next para we start. So this para children depend upon the restoration period. Okay. So let's we start the restoration period drama and dramatist. When the Charles II came back with the restoration of 1660, the theater were reopened. The restoration comedy achieved its peculiar existence. Drama developed into class drama with upper class ethos. It lasted beyond this period into the first decade of the 18th century. Comedy in the early 18th century declined into a sentimentalism. It became comedy of manner. George Ithers was the most important exponent. From such depth, the drama was rescued by Oliver Goldsmith and Richard Sheridan. With Sheridan, something of the brilliance of the restoration dialogue returned into comedy, but with the more genial atmosphere. The characters were firmly presented with clarity reminiscent of Johnson, but with no depth in the Sheridan's world, no new interpretation of human nature. In this, he was nearer to Oscar Wilde than to Jones. So children, after the restoration, a very difficult kind of dramatic literature was produced. Here some notable dramatists came in light. They are Chapman, Thomas Middleton, Webster, Dekker, George Ithers. With the restoration of 1660, Charles II resumed power and the theater were reopened. So children, with the restoration in 1660, Charles II resumed power and the theater was reopened. The restoration comedy reached its peak during this period. Drama developed into class drama, which was based on characteristics and belief of the upper class. It lasted beyond this period into the first decade of 18th century. Now, in the 17th century, the enclosed theater gained importance. There was increasing attention to science device and theaters become private. Children, dramatist George Ithurens was famously known for his work on the comedy of manners in this period. So children, 18th century's notable dramatists are Oliver Goldsmith and Richard Sheridan. See children, in 18th century, sentimental comedy or sentimentalism, we can say, gained importance, which focused on producing emotion rather than laughter. This was a reaction on the comedy of manners. Children, the comedy of manners was revived later again by Oliver Goldsmith and Richard Sheridan. See children, in doing so, they kept the original brilliance of dialogues of the Restoration period, but removed the controversial and immortal element to give it a friendlier tone. The characters were firmly presented with clarity, just like in Jonson's work, which belongs to the comedy of manner in genre drama. Children, they had no depth in Sheridan's world and no new interpretation of human nature. Children, in this way we can say Sheridan's work was thus more like the wight who was to come than Jonson. So in this period's notable work is children, All for Love, that is a tragedy. It is written by George Dryden. And next one is The Way of the World. It is a comedy, it written by William Congreve. So children, next type of drama, that is modern drama. The modern theater with its picture frame stage, its actress taking female parts, its a movable scenery designed to create a visual image of the local of each scene, and its artificial light was developed during the Restoration period. There is clear influence of France on theater, the audience and the थीम्स. सो चिल्ड्रन, मॉडर्न थिएटर में अभी फीमेल एक्ट्रेस क्या करने लगी, फीमेल पार्ट को निभाने लगी. कि पहले क्या होता था, मेल जो एक्टर होते थे वही फीमेल पार्ट निभाते थे. तो हम कह सकते हैं द एलिमेंट्स ऑफ मॉडर्न थिएटर लाइक द पिक्चर फ्रेम स्टेज, एक्ट्रेस टेकिंग फीमेल पार्ट्स बिफोर द क्लोजिंग ऑफ थिएटर, ऑल रोल्स वर प्लेड बाय मेल. मूवेबल सीनरी एंड आर्टिफिशियल लाइट वॉज डेवलप्ड ड्यूरिंग द रेस्टोरेशन पीरियड. वेल, और देयर इज अ क्लियर इन्फ्लुएंस ऑफ द फ्रेंच ऑन थिएटर. द ड्रामा ऑफ द अर्ली 19th सेंचुरी वॉज ऑन द होल ऑन द वे टू डिक्लाइन फॉर मेनी रीजन. द थिएटर वॉज होम मेनली टू इरेगुलर स्पेक्टिकल, melodrama and fate. So question arises, what is meant by melodrama? Children, melodrama means overreact sound drama, and farce means a comic romantic work using horseplay for crude characters. A simple external reason can be found in the monopoly. We can say monopoly means children, ekadhikar. The monopoly held by the two houses, Convent Garden and the Drury Lane, for the performance of serious drama. The audiences which gathered to the 19th century theatre had not the intelligence or the imagination of the Elizabethan audience. The danger in the 19th century theatre was that above all it was unrelated to the life of the time. The changes in the structure of society had so modified the human personality itself that a new interpretation was essential. Now see, in 19th century the drama was declined, that have many reasons. Among of that, one reason was that the exclusive legal rights to showcase performance of serious drama were held by only two influenced theaters, that is the house of Covent Garden and Drury Lane. And second reason is the audience of 19th century theater did not have the intelligence or imagination of the Elizabethan audience, unlike the Elizabethan years audience. More than anything, the problem was that the play did not relate to 19th century life. The changes in the structure of society had influenced the personality of people so greatly that a new approach was needed. Essential means children, needed. Ibsen, the great Norwegian dramatist of 19th century, dominates the realistic drama. He develops modernist, realistic, social and psychological drama like The Dollhouse, Ghost and An Enemy of the People. Ibsen, jo 19th century ka dramatist tha, he dominates the realistic drama. He develops his new ideal type of drama that we can say he develops modernist, realistic, social and psychological dramas. And they are The Doll's House, Ghost and Enemy of the People. They are far more subtle in stagecraft and profound in thought than anything in the modern English theatre. So whatever drama is written, they are far more subtle in stagecraft. And that's why his drama is not mostly liked by a more dramatist. But it was only George Bernard Shaw who was deeply influenced and affected by Ibsen's innovative contributions and experiments. So whatever Ibsen started or developed modernist, realistic, socialist and psychologistic drama, by that drama, only that time a great dramatist George Bernard Shaw only influenced by Ibsen's innovative contributions and experimentation. He was the most brilliant playwright of his time. So children, George Bernard Shaw was the most brilliant playwright of his time. He alone had understood the greatness of Ibsen and he was determined that his own play should also be a vehicle for idea. The responsibilities of elevation of an English drama to the brilliance of Norwegian fell with Oscar Wilde and G.B. Shaw in the late 19th and 20th century. So children, in late 19th and 20th century, only George Bernard Shaw and Oscar Wilde had alone understood the greatness of Ibsen, and George Bernard Shaw was determined that his own idea play should also be a vehicle for idea. So the responsibility of elevation of the English drama to the brilliance of Norwegian fell with Oscar Wilde and G.B. Shaw. So when we say in short children, in late 19th century and earliest 20th century, there were some notable dramatists. They are Ibsen, George Bernard Shaw and Oscar Wilde. And they done their notable work in this period are The Importance of Being Earnest. It is written by Oscar Wilde, and Candida by G.B. Shaw, and A Doll House and Enemy of People. These two plays are written by Henrik Ibsen. The 20th century showed a talent in the drama with which the 19th century could not complete. As Grenville, Baker, John Galsworthy, S.T. John, Irwin were some of the playwrights who explored contemporary problems. S.T. John Irwin's had been associated with a group of Irish dramatists whose work was normally produced in the Abbey Theatre in Dublin. Much that is based in the modern drama in English developed from this moment on. Its originator was Lady Gregory with W.B. East and J.M. Signe. They were the most important dramatists of this Irish revival, who used a sense of tragic irony, a violent species of humor and rich and highly flavored language. Children, 20th century showed a talent in drama with which 19th century is not able to complete or is not able to show. So this century, the notable dramatists are the H. Greville Baker, John Galsworthy, S.T. John Irwin, Lady Gregory, W.B. East, J.M. Signe. Children, S.T. John Irwin had been associated with a group of Irish dramatists whose work was normally produced in the Abbey Theatre in Dublin. Children, the best work of modern English drama were developed from this moment, which is known as Irish Literary Revival. Children, notable dramatist of Irish Literary Revival, that is Lady Gregory, W.B. East and J.M. Signe. They were most important dramatists of this Irish revival, who used a sense of tragic irony, a violent species of humor and rich and highly flavored language in their work. So children, इस century में जो पहले की century में drama नहीं कर पाई थी, वो 20th century में drama ने कर दिखाया. इसमें drama के द्वारा जो play किया जाता था, उसमें contemporary के problems दिखाए गए. इस era में ढेर सारे dramatists हैं, उसमें से some notable dramatists हैं H. Grenville Baker, John Galsworthy, S.T. John Irwin, Lady Gregory, W.B. East and J.M. Signe. So children, ये जो dramatist थे, इन्होंने most important role निभाया इस era में, और इन्होंने इस इरा में जो ड्रामा लिखे वह ड्रामा आयरिश रिवाइवल ड्रामे के नाम से प्रसिद्ध हुआ। और ये ड्रामेटिस्ट ट्रेजिक आयरनी, अ वायलेंट स्पेसिस ऑफ ह्यूमर, अ रिच एंड हाईली फ्लेवर्ड लैंग्वेज को यूज करते थे। टी एस इलियट एक्सपेरिमेंटेड विथ ग्रीक ट्रेजिडी इन द अर्ली 40s ऑफ 20th सेंचुरी। चिल्ड्रेन, ड्रामेटिस्ट टी एस इलियट एक्सपेरिमेंटेड विथ ग्रीक ट्रेजिडी इन 1940 मीन्स अर्ली ऑफ द 20th सेंचुरी। अदर ड्रामेटिस्ट ऑफ द मॉडर्न इरा, जॉन ऑसबॉर्न रोट ऑन पीपल हु ग्रीव अप आफ्टर द सेकेंड वर्ल्ड वॉर। किंग्सले एमिस रोट अबाउट फ्रस्ट्रेटेड एंटी एस्टेब्लिश यंग पीपल। ऑसबॉर्निस लुक बैक इन एंगर बॉट अ न्यू विटेलिटी टू द थिएटर सीन। इट वॉज मोर अ कल्चरल फेनोमेनॉन देन द वर्क ऑफ लिटरेचर। अदर इम्पोर्टेंट प्ले राइट ऑफ द मॉडर्न इरा इंक्लूड एंटोन चेको, बर्टोल्ड ब्रेज, यूजेनी ओनील, आर्थर मिलर, टेनिसी विलियम्स, यूजीन ओनेस्को, सैमुअल बीकेट एंड हारोल्ड पिंटर। चिल्ड्रन, एस टी जॉन एरविन हैड बीन एसोसिएटेड विथ अ ग्रुप ऑफ आयरिश ड्रामेटिस्ट हुज वर्क वॉज नॉर्मली प्रोड्यूस्ड इन द एबे थिएटर इन डबलिन। Now for children, T.S. Eliot experimented with a Greek tragedy in 1940. Already I say that we can say beginning of the 20th century. In this century, notable work are Pygmalion by G.B. Shaw, Murder in the Cathedral, it is a poetic drama by T.S. Eliot. And this era's notable dramatists are John Osborne, Kingsley Amis, Anton Chekhov, Bertolt Brecht, Eugene O'Neill, Arthur Miller, Tennessee William, Eugenie Onesco, Samuel Beckett, and the Harold Pinter. And notable dramatists of the theater of the absurd are Eugenie Onesco, Samuel Beckett, Harold Pinter. Johnson Osborne wrote on the poor quality of life of people who grew up after the Second World War. Osborne's look back in anger brought new life to the theatre scene. It was more a cultural phenomenon than a work of लिटरेचर। सो चिल्ड्रन, जो ऑप्शनी का लुक बैक एंड एंगर था, ये क्या किया, इसने थिएटर को एक नया जीवन प्रदान कर दिया। इट वॉज मोर अ कल्चरल फेनोमेनॉन ऑफ देन अ वर्क ऑफ लिटरेचर। किंग्सलेस एम्स रोट अबाउट द यंग पीपल हु वर एंग्री विद द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ सोसाइटी। किंग्सले ने जो अपने ड्रामा लिखे उनका उस ड्रामा को लिखने का उद्देश्य था कि द पीपल्स who were angry with the government and society. And angry young men, both Johnson, Osborne and Kingsley's Aim came to belong to this group of writers which earned its name because of its represented writers who were frustrated with the traditional British society. And children, this period's notable works are Look Back in Anger by Johnson Osborne and Waiting for Godot by Samuel Beckett. Okay, so in this way children, we learn a modern drama. And in first of all, we learn the Victorian period of modern drama, that is started in 1837 and Victorian period is ended in 1901. Then afterwards we learn the modern period theater of drama, that is started from 1901 and its end in 1945. Then afterwards we learn the postmodern theater or postmodern theater drama, that we can say postmodern era drama, that is started in 1945 to 2000. So let's learn the fourth type of drama, that is the Indian drama theatre. Children, earliest seed of modern Indian drama can be found in the Sanskrit. From the 1st century AD, Mahabhashya by Patanjali provides a feasible date for the beginning of theatre in India. Children, earlier jo starting mein jo seed pada modern Indian drama ka, it can be found in Sanskrit. Sabse pehle ya Sanskrit mein hame dikha. Which century? From the 1st century AD, Mahabhashya by Patanjali. The major source of evidence is a treaty on theatre, that we can say Natya Shastra, by Bharat Muni, in the most complete work of dramatology in the ancient world. It gives mythological account of the origin of theatre. Modern Indian drama, however, has influenced from all over the world as well as Sanskrit and
Urdu tradition.
So in short, children, we can say the seed of modern India drama can be found in the Sanskrit drama in 1st century AD. Mahabhasya by Patanjali is considered to be the first work of theatre in India. A treaty on theatre, that is, we can say Natya Sastra by Bharat Muni, is the most complete work of dramatology in the ancient world. It provides a mythological account of the origin of Indian theatre. Modern Indian drama has influence from all over the world, as well as from Sanskrit and Urdu traditions.
Children, after completing a topic, a short history of drama, where we study regarding introduction to English drama or theatre. इसमें हमने folk theatre के बारे में पढ़ा, minstrel के बारे में पढ़ा. See children, this is the folk minstrel dance. Then we studied regarding the amphitheatre, which is established by Roman in England. We know children, amphitheatre is a open theatre. Then we studied miracle plays. See children, this type of miracle plays we studied. Then afterwards we studied regarding morality plays. See, these are the example of some morality plays. Then we taken information regarding some dramatists. Among of that, one is Thomas Kyd, next one Christopher Marlowe, and the father of English drama, William Shakespeare.
These three dramatists are belongs to the Elizabethan era, or we can say Restoration theater period. Then afterward we studied regarding many more dramatists like Chapman, Thomas Middleton, Webster, Dacre, Oliver Goldsmith, Richard Sheridan. Then afterwards we taken information regarding the Ibsen, who is a great Norwegian dramatist, and follower of Ibsen is George Bernard Shaw. Regarding this dramatist also we taken him a lot of information, and we also taken information regarding the H. Granville Baker, John Galsworthy, St. John Irvine, Lady Gregory, W.B. Yeats, J.M. Sidney. So in this way we again taken information regarding the 28th century dramatists, that is Anton Chekhov, Bertolt Brecht, Igni O'Neill, then Arthur Miller, Tennessee Williams, Igni Onikov, Samuel Beckett, and Hernold Pinter. Then afterwards we taken information regarding the Indian theatre, how it is started, or iska origin kahan se hua tha. Then afterwards we studied regarding the Indian theatre, jiska origin Sanskrit भाषा के ड्रामा से हुआ था, जिसका हमें एविडेंस मिलता है ए ट्रीटी ऑन थिएटर, जिसे हम नाट्य शास्त्र कहते हैं, उसके द्वारा हमें जो भारत मुनि के द्वारा कंप्लीट किया गया है, उसी से हमें इस एशियंट ड्रामा के वर्ल्ड के बारे में पता चलता है. तो चिल्ड्रन, इन सभी के बेस पे जो क्वेश्चंस आपको एग्जाम में आएंगे, अब हम उसके बारे में पढ़ेंगे. मीन्स नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न द क्वेश्चन विच विल कम ऑन बेस्ड ऑन दिस थिंग व्हाट वी स्टडीड. सो चिल्ड्रन, बेस्ड ऑन द टॉपिक, क्वेश्चन नंबर वन, मैच द कंटेंट्स गिवेन इन कॉलम ए विद द कंटेंट्स गिवेन इन कॉलम बी. सी फर्स्ट कॉलम, एलेगोरीज प्ले, ओरिजिन ऑफ ड्रामा, शेक्सपियर इरा, किड एंड मार्लो डेवलप्ड this form of drama. Roots of modern theatre were developed in this period. See, second column given tragedy, Renaissance, restoration period, folk theatre, morality play. First one is allegorical play. It is also known as morality play. Second one is origins of drama. Origin of drama is started from folk theatre. Next is Shakespeare's era. Shakespeare's era is known as Renaissance period. Next one, Kyd and Marlowe developed this form of drama. Which form of drama Kyd and Marlowe developed? They developed the tragedy type of drama. And fifth one is roots of modern theatre were developed in this period. In restoration period, roots of modern theatre were developed. Next question, question number two. Match the contributions given in column A with the playwrights given in column B. See, contributions first. Restoration dramatists were influenced by this comedy genius. So, restoration dramatists were influenced by Ben Jonson. Next is given, most important dramatist of the comedy of manner genre is George Ithers. Third one is discovery of the blank verse as a theoretical medium.
is discovered by Thomas Kate. Fourth one, the dramatist who dominated modern drama is Ibsen. Now children, question number 3. Match the type of drama given in column A with its description given in column B. Column A, heroic drama. Children, in heroic drama, the hero is a powerful character. Second one is pathetic drama. Pathetic drama, it is based on the hardship of woman. Third one is stream of consciousness. Stream of consciousness tries to depict the continuous flow of thoughts of the human mind. Now, fourth one, children, absurd play, or we can say theater of absurd. This drama focuses on questioning one's existence and the meaning of life and its purpose. Now, poetic drama. So, children, poetic drama, here characters speak in poetic words. And sixth one is radio drama. Radio drama used only an audio component to reveal the plot. Next question, children. Question number 4. Give one word for the following. First, an oval building with open air seating built in ancient Roman for viewing entertainment event is known as amphitheater. Already I shown children amphitheater. Now second one, a verse without a rhyme but with a regular meter, that is known as blank verse. Next is a person who supports an idea or a belief and convinces others of its advantage, that is exponent. Next one, tending to remind one of a particular person or place, that is we can say reminiscence. Now fifth one, to have sole control of a service, we can say monopoly. Now next question, children, that is question number 5. See, choose the correct alternatives. So yahan par jo aapko diya hai children, see, name given, Baker, T.S. Eliot, like that, all names are given. So here sentence is given, regarding that sentence which dramatist matched, that you have to choose. Okay, see, first one, a dramatist on whom the responsibility of elevation of English drama fell upon in the late 19th century. That person is Oscar Wilde. Next, a dramatist from the modern era who explored contemporary problem. That person is who is? Barker. Now, third one, a dramatist who was one of the originator of the Irish revival. That person is Lady Gregory. Fourth one, a dramatist who experimented with Greek tragedy. That person name is T.S. Eliot. Now fourth one, a dramatist whose work was known as a cultural phenomenon. Name is Jonson Osborne. Next one, a dramatist whose work on dramatology in the ancient world is considered to be the most complete work. Person is Bharat Muni. Now next question, answer the following. First, mortality play of the medieval period were allegories. Explain. Answer, mortality play of the medieval period were play in which the character themselves represented abstract moral quality of good and bad nature. Thus they were known as allegories. Next, write a description of 16th century public theater. Answer, public theater in 16th century was different from the modern theater, as it was open to the sky, did not have artificial lighting, and stage was a raised platform with the recess at the back supported by pillar. There was no curtain, and the area around main platform could accommodate audience on three sides, whereas the entire theater was surrounded by galleries. Third sub question, state the features of modern theater which were developed during the restoration period. See answer, the picture frame stage, the female part being played by woman actor, the moving of scenery depending upon the locality in which the scene is set, in the artificial lighting, where all features of modern theater which were developed during the restoration period. See, here children, depending mein G cut gaya hai aur theater mein E. So please remember. See children, next question. Mention the reasons for the decline of early 19th century drama. Answer, early 19th century drama declined because of the following reason. First reason, the House of Covent Garden and the Drury Lane were the only two theaters which were given the exclusive right for showcasing performances of serious drama. Next reason is the audience of 19th century theater did not have the intelligence or imagination of the audience of the Elizabethan era. Next reason is the theater in the 19th century was unrelated to life at the time. And fourth one, the changes in the structure of society had modified the human personality itself to get a great extent, and this called for a new approach to theater. Next question, children. Name any four period of history of British drama. See answer. The period of history of British drama are follow. See, you have to write only four. I given six. See, first one medieval period, second one the Renaissance period, third one Restoration period, fourth one Victorian period, fifth one the modern period, and sixth one the postmodern era. So among of six you have to write four, and this question will become an exam for 2 marks. Now next question on this topic, stated type of drama each from any four period of history. See answer. The period of history of British drama are each well known for their characteristic plays. These are the following types. So first one is medieval period. Here didactic plays, mystery plays, miracle plays, cycle plays, morality plays. See next period is Renaissance period. Here tragic, comedy, melancholy, revenge plays are going. Next period is Restoration period. In this period, heroic drama, pathetic drama, restoration comedy were played on the stage. Next is Victorian period. In Victorian period, children, all type of plays are played by the dramatist. Next one, modern period. In modern period, stream of consciousness, absurd play, poetic drama, radio drama is going on. And last one is postmodern period. In this period, almost all type of dramas, kitchen sink drama is going on. Next question, enlist the influencers of modern Indian drama. So, क्या करना है आपको? List out करना है modern India drama के influencer को. See, answer. Modern Indian drama has influences from all over the world, including Sanskrit and Urdu tradition. So, in this way, children, in this lecture, we taken information regarding a short history of drama. And we studied Introduction to English Theatre, Elizabethan and Restoration Theatre, and then we studied Modern Theatre, and afterwards we taken information regarding the Indian Theatre, and lastly we learn the question answer regarding this topic, which will may come in your exam. Thank you, children.